Hello students, in last video we have seen botnets, how they are created and used and points to secure the system from them. Now we will see the attack vector. An attack vector is a path or a method by which attacker can gain access to the computer or to a network server to deliver a payload. Attack vectors enables attackers to exploit the system vulnerabilities. It means the attack vector enables attackers to make use of any type of weakness or a failure present in a computer so that he can easily perform unauthorized actions on a computer system. Attack vectors may include viruses, email attachments, worms, web pages, pop-up windows, instant messages, chat rooms, etc. By using these all, they can attack on a system or they can gain access to the computer unauthorizedly. The most common malicious payloads are viruses, Trojan horses, worms and spywares. Okay, here we are using one word, that is payload. Okay, in technical terms, I think you have seen this payload word in computer networks. There it is necessary data being carried out within a packet or a other transmission unit. Okay, but in cyber security, in this scenario, payload means malicious activity that the attacker performs. Okay, the next is how attack is launched by using these attack vectors. The first is attack by email. Here the hostile or malicious content is either embedded in message or a linked to a message. Spam is always a carrier for scams or a frauds or a some malicious actions. Okay, this is like a email attachment. They can include hostile, that is nothing but malicious content in those attachments, or they can embed that in a message, or they can link to that message whichever they are sending by email. By doing this, they can perform some malicious actions. The second one is attachments. Okay, malicious attachments install malicious computer code in our computer system. This code could be a virus, Trojan horse, spyware or any kind of malware. Attachments attempt to install the malicious code as soon as you open them. Okay, suppose an attachment came, for example by an email. If we click on that attachment, immediately it can inserted the malicious code in our system. The next is hackers. Hackers or crackers use variety of hacking tools and social engineering to gain access to our computers or our online accounts. They often install Trojan horses to command the computers for their own use. Okay, already we seen who are hackers, who are crackers and what they will do. And we also seen social engineering, how they will commit cyber crime by using a social engineering methods. Most of the hackers, they use some hacking tools and social engineering to gain access to computer unauthorizedly. Next is attack by deception. Here they will use social engineering and hoax messages or hoax emails to commit a cyber crime. The next one is heedless guest. It means attack by web pages. We can call this as a attack by web page. Here, counterfeit websites are used to extract personal information. Okay, counterfeit websites means fake websites. They will look like genuine websites. If he or she think that they are doing business with the website which is trustworthy, they will really share personal information like address, credit card number and expiry date of that card. Okay, if they are thinking that website is a genuine one, they will share this all information with that. Pop-up websites may install spyware, adware or trojans. Okay, some pop-ups will come in websites, no, those will install spyware, adware or trojans without user's knowledge. The next one is attack by worms. Many worms are delivered as a email attachments. In most cases, a firewall block system worms. Many of these system worms install Trojan horse, and next they begin scanning of the internet from the computer, and they will infect that computer, and they will start looking for other computers to infect which are connected to that internet. If worm is successful in this, it propagates or spreads rapidly or fastly. The next is malicious macros. Microsoft Excel and Microsoft Word, these are some examples for macros. A macro is something which spreads quickly in cybersecurity. Okay, in cybersecurity, a macro is something which spreads quickly. So these are used for malicious purposes. The next is foistware or a sneakware, we can call this. This is the software that adds hidden components to a system on the sly. It means the software which downloads or adds hidden components to a computer without user's knowledge. Spyware is the most common form of foistware. The next is viruses. These are the malicious computer codes that return to alter the operations of a computers and is designed to spread from one computer to another. Nowadays, virus vectors include email attachments, downloaded files, worms, Trojan horses, etc. Thank you.